Hi everyone. In this tutorial, we will create a cursor animation with an image trail effect. The images will follow the cursor when we move the mouse. We'll use HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and GSAP for this project. Let's get started. Let's begin with the HTML. We have a simple structure. Inside the container, we have a heading with two H1 elements. We'll insert the images using JavaScript. Let's move on to CSS. Now we'll style the heading and images with CSS. We'll apply this font to the heading. Then we style the container to take the full screen with a dark background. We align the heading to the center vertically and horizontally. We also style the text with a glowing effect. Now we create a class for the images. They have a specific width and height. And we hide the pointer events so they don't block the mouse. Let's move on to JavaScript. In JavaScript, we will create the image trail effect and control the animations. First, let's add the GSAP by using a CDN link. Then we start by creating an array of image paths. We get the container element. We also set some variables to track the image index and last mouse position. We use distance threshold to set the distance between the images. This controls how far the mouse must move before a new image appears. We create a new image element. We use this class to apply styles to the images. We set the image source from the array. Then we add the image to the container. We change the index to show the next image. After the last image, it goes back to the first one. We set the image's starting position, scale, opacity, and random rotation using GSAP. Then we animate the image to appear and grow. After a short delay, the image will shrink and disappear. When the animation is complete, we remove the image from the page. This cleans up the image after the animation finishes. If we don't do this, many invisible images stay in memory, making the page slower. Now we listen for the mouse move event. When we move the mouse, we calculate the distance from the last position. If the distance is bigger than the threshold, we create a new image at the mouse position. Then we update the last position. However, the images may appear larger than the heading on smaller screens. So we add a media query to make the images smaller. Also, we need to change distance threshold based on screen size. We use a shorter distance on small screens and a longer distance on large screens. Finally, we listen for window resize to update the distance threshold. And there you have it. We've created an image trail effect using GSAP, Don't forget to like and subscribe for more creative projects. Thanks for watching.